The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Robert in New Jersey. Hey, Robert, what's going on?
Hey, Tom. A great show.
Thank you so much.
For years. You got a great thing. I've been listening to you for over a decade. That's amazing. You've done a great job.
I appreciate it, man. Appreciate you growling and prowling out here with us.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet. At TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Miracles happen to those who believe. Yesterday's gone. Tomorrow's not here. What are you doing right now? Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 83, NASDAQ up 35, S&P's up 8.5. Gold contract up $8.30, traded $1,110 an ounce. Silver up 8 cents at $14.60 an ounce, $14.66 an ounce. Platinum flat at $9.81 an ounce. You got copper up 2 pennies at $2.45 a pound. Light sweet crude up $1.49, trading out at $45.65 a barrel. Bonds, 10-year, down 11 ticks, 127.02, 30 off 1 full point. At 153.20, King dollar down 544 ticks, 95.46. The euro is up 77 at 112, and the yen is flat at 120.60. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Wanna know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. We'll start with the SPY. What you have with the SPY right now, folks, is this. SPY is trading at a price point of 195.78, and what we have out here is that what the market tried to do yesterday. Well, the market got to a price point. The SPY got to a price point of 199.47. You had 149 million shares traded. Bottom line, failed on price, failed on volume as it was coming into the minor swing of the 28th. Bottom line, you're coming into the downdraft of 346 million. That's the supply line. That supply line is vicious, folks. Now, what are we doing out here today? Well, check it out. Today, you've gone to a price point of 197.25. It's rejecting that price. We've done 113 million. So your correlation goes like this. Let's say we do 133 million. We do 20 million on the next hour. That'd be 133 million versus 149 of yesterday versus 339 versus 346. Bottom line, folks, this market is into that supply line and people are moving out of equities. Well, you go look at the NDX 100, the 3Qs. Same setup in the 3Qs. What you have with the 3Qs is this. High of yesterday, you had the high of yesterday was 106.31. We did 47 million shares. Thus far today, we've done 33. So let's say we're going to do 40. Also rejecting price. If we go over, I'm going to show you, we're going to look at the futures next because the futures are really intriguing here. And this is what the market has tried to do. And, you know, it's been trying to get to higher price. Bottom line is that you have sellers inside this market. And the sellers, each and every time you're coming up to, let me see, put this on a 10 minute. Okay. So if we put this on a 10 minute, it gets a little bit clearer as to what this baby is trying to do and has done. Okay. So if we look at the E-minis first, what you're going to see is this, is that we got to a price point today. Issues. We got, overnight, the S&P's got the 1967. At the open today, you had selling. They brought them right down to 1928. All day long, market's been going higher. It got back up to the 1965 area. This is on the S&P's. coming into the close, you've had the first couple sell downs. You know, we'll see. I suspect the looks like the we're up $9 right now. Bottom line, it looks I suspect it's going to end up being flat. You know, where I'm going with that, by the way, folks, I'm going at 11:20 this morning. You see, once we just came back under, well, we're not under it. And as soon as you're into 1950, and right, we're at 1951 right now, that puts on the table 1940. We go take a look at the NQs. Now, the NQs were stronger than the E-minis today, okay? And every day it seems to be a little bit different. But one, of course, is, well, it doesn't have to be stronger than the other. In this particular case, what you do have is the NQs are stronger today. Bottom line, however, the NQs were still going into, if you see this, this is a trip in itself, man, because the NQs were going into the downdraft at 09:30 yesterday morning. It took out, and it took it out with volume, by the way. When we spoke, when we got higher at 1:30 this afternoon, it had some juice behind that move. It took those two small intraday swing points out with volume. However, that being said, what it was actually doing was coming into that 9:30 bar from yesterday morning, and that 9:30 bar from yesterday morning, folks, has another seller, or the same seller in it, and bottom line is that they pushed more contracts into the marketplace. Gold contract, what do we have with gold? Gold out here today trading at a price point of 1110. And what we have with gold, we still want more price spread, volume. We need both. The bottom line is that gold did hold today, okay? Yesterday, gold gets down to a price point of the $1,110. It had 30% lighter volume, which is going into. It's up $8, but we need price spread. We need price spread, and we need volume behind that move. We go take a look at the silver market. What we have with silver is this. Silver right now is up, silver's trading at $14.66. Silver inside the $14.42 is still saying silver wants higher price. Silver also needs wide price spread, accelerated volume, all of the above. Bonds. Now, the bonds have continued to give the most consistent information in the marketplace. If we go over to the bond market, what you're going to see is that the 10-year rejected lower price yesterday, had lighter volume. Today, you're down 11 ticks. Yesterday, we did 1.2 million contracts. The 1.2 million contracts was going into 1.3 million. Bottom line, you're backing down today, and you're backing down right now with 891,000. That's still saying bonds want higher price. We go take a look at the 30-year bond. What we have with the 30-year bond is this. 30-year bond, USZ. 30-year bond right now is down one full point. You're at 226,000 contracts. You know, you're below the 30-year is turning around saying that you can test the 152.14 from yesterday once again. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. You have Dow Industrials up 79, NASDAQ up 36, S&Ps are up 8. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full custom capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, 2x currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now are up 92. You get the NASDAQ up by 41. S&Ps are up by 9.5. Inside the Dow, strength inside the Dow. Here you go. This is what you have happening. The strength is Apple. Apple is the leader. Apple's up 261. Pfizer is next at 66 cents. Merck is up 83. And United Health is up 180. The laggards bringing the Dow down. Walmart is down 85, Caterpillar is off 62, United Technologies 52, and DuPont is down 23. Inside the NDX 100, what you have, the leaders inside the NDX 100, Liberty Media, Clack is up $1.85, Gilead is up 367. Bringing it downtown, what do you have? Wynn is down 372 at 69.32. Wynn Resorts, folks, is in big trouble. It's an ABC structure on the way down. It's trading at 69. It's a 56 A to B equals C to D. It's broken its swing point this morning with volume. You get Dollar Tree, another disaster. That's down $1.38, $1.93 rather. SBA Communications is off $3, and NXPI is down $2.22. Let's go to Laurie and say we'll go to Laurie in St. Pete first, then we're going to come up to Andy. Hey, Laurie, how you doing?
Hey, Tom, thanks for talking to me. I spoke with you yesterday, and we talked about BAC, CBX, and XLM.
Yeah.
And I'm an upper citizen, and I'm at the point now where it's hard for me to even spend a lot of time on this and try to worry about it, but I have done very badly. And so now I'm trying to get into some stocks that, even though I can't buy many stocks, but at least I'd like to buy some that are good quality stocks that I can probably make some money and not worry so much about what's going on. And the first one is PG.
Okay, so let's talk about the aspect of not worry, right?
Yes.
There's unfortunately, inside the marketplace, there's not such a word. You know, I mean, there isn't, right? That's you know.
That's true. I understand
it's,
that.
Yeah, it's a tough one. I mean, but I know what you're saying, okay? But if we look at Procter & Gamble first, you know, we're at 68, 35. I'd let this first get down to somewhere around the 63.95 area and see, you know, if the volume continues. You know, that thing last month got killed. You know, it went down $10. I wouldn't be biting just yet.
No, I wasn't planning on it, but okay. I was just kind of wanting to watch to see what level. Or
which is great. No, that's a great way of doing it, because what does end up happening, this buy is not going to be easy. You know. I suspect the way the buy is going to come in is that, you know, I think I said to you yesterday or after you get off, we will not be getting any calls of anyone wanting to buy any stock. That's just kind of how the market goes. It's so weird that when you think about that, and that's just kind of how it works, though.
Yes.
If you, Bristol-Myers, I wouldn't touch at all.
Oh, really?
Yeah, the reason being is this. Like, Bristol-Myers is at 58, and it's like, you know, there's just, you know, this thing can go down to like 29 or something. You know, so it's like, okay, what's going to come out of the woodwork here inside Bristol-Myers? I don't know. And it's really intriguing because when you bring up Bristol-Myers, it looks like that they're saying that the P.E. is all of, they're saying the P.E. is 31. That's huge. You're paying $31 for every dollar of earnings. You
okay.
Know?
Mm-hmm. Right.
Let me just look at something. So you got, what are the stocks? You got the oil stocks would be pretty good. Let me just look at Oxy for a second. Yes, you can't own all oil stocks, but Occidental's at 67. Yeah, 56 is a number on that. Let me just see something. They pay 4.4% too. You know, I'll keep my, you know, thinking hat on, you know, for you as we look at some of these stocks. I think I get a feeling what you'd like. You want solid stocks that you figure are not going to go out of business, right? That you might get a small, you know, dividend, right? Well, I'll keep my mind on that when I'm doing this newsletter every day.
Okay, I was going to ask you. I'll forget about the BMY one, but consider PG probably. You think or
yeah,
not?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
How about Verizon and AT&T?
My mother works for AT&T. I have the original certificates, and I've owned them ever since then, and I still do. I mean, it's turned out great. It's like pretty crazy, you know, because.
But that was many years ago. I don't have that many years.
But they pay big dividends. I mean, if we do Verizon, you know, that's almost paying a 5% dividend. They're not going to go out of business. Same thing, though. They're at highs. You know, you just got to let this play out for a while. I suspect the way that the way the market is right now, okay, it's highly volatile. Volatility doesn't just stop overnight.
Right. Okay.
You know, so I would just keep your cash in your pocket right now.
Right.
For this particular, you know.
Well, I was just trying to get an idea of what I need to look for so that when it comes around that time, I'll be ready to do something about it.
I would look for the big companies that have been around for a long period of time. You'll make, you know, they're not going to be rocket ships, but you don't need a rocket ship. You need something that, you know, is going to, that you can sleep at night and, you know, they're going to pay you some dividends. And let me just look at Boeing for a second. Boeing could be one of them, too. You know, Boeing's down off 155. You're at 133. You know, Boeing would be decent at, my God, 109. If it breaks 109, it can go to 77. So just let it be a bit. But there are large companies that you could build yourself a decent portfolio. I suspect that, you know, you still need 3 or 4 months here. But that's the way you're doing it is the way to do it. Because what I've found is this. If you get set up before the fact, like when I opened that real estate fund, right, I was waiting for 2 years to open that thing, okay? And I knew it. I felt I knew what the numbers were that I wanted, right?
Right.
And it's the same with the market, okay? If you're prepared before the fact, it's different, okay? Because then your plan's in place and you're, you know, it doesn't mean it's going to be right, but your probability, I think, goes up dramatically.
Right. Well, that's what I'm trying to do. Tom, what I'll do is I'll keep in touch with you, and we'll kind of...
And as I'm going over these in the morning, I know what you want to do. I've seen...
Yeah, but I can't listen to every one of your shows.
You don't have to. But my point is, now that I know what you want to do, you know, even the next week, week and a half, I can... You know, I look at stocks every day, so if I see one, I'll just jot it down. I'm good with notes.
Okay, very good.
Okay.
I'll call you back.
Have a great one.
All right, thanks.
Have a safe one. Now, folks, let's go over to our man, Mr. Andy Hecht. And don't forget, folks, Andy does an outstanding show every Tuesday, Thursday, right here at TFNN. Get it right on your cell phone, TFNN.MOBI. Now, we start programming, folks, at 8 o'clock in the morning. We go from 8 o'clock in the morning to 6 in the afternoon. Our man, Mr. John Logan, kicks us off. In fact, John is on the plane from North Carolina to here. We're going to see him tonight. He's going to do the show here tomorrow morning, and then he's heading from here to his headquarters out in the Philippines, okay? So when you want a great market wrap, that's a great way to start your day. Now, Andy also has an outstanding newsletter. It's the Technomento Commodity Report. You can come over to our website, test drive it right now, 30 days, absolutely free. So check it out as we're coming into this break. We're going to be coming back with our man, Mr. Andy Heck, and we are going to be talking commodities, baby. Dow Industrials are up 48, NASDAQ is up 30, S&Ps are up 4. Market just can't handle higher price, folks, just can't handle it. We're going to be right back.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now are up 47, NASDAQ's up 30, S&Ps are up 4.5. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Andy Heck. What's going on, brother?
Hey, Tom, what's going on?
Just a little growling and prowling.
I hear you. You know, it's kind of a waiting game. I see here. For example, grain markets are waiting for the tomorrow big report out. World Agricultural Supply and Demand Estimates report comes out at noon tomorrow, and those markets will likely move after that. At least,
yeah, and you know, in fact, when we're talking the grain market, folks, we're going to have Sal Ghiberti on tomorrow too.
Right,
kick the show off him with him in the afternoon, so that'll be great.
that'll be great. He'll be able to go over those reports and dissect them for you and tell us all what's going to happen, you know, with the grain markets and what it all means from a supply and demand point of view. And then, hey, all the other markets are waiting for the Fed.
I guess so.
Yeah. I mean, the commodity markets are certainly.
Oh yeah,
Commodity markets are, because we, you know, it's kind of a coin toss now, right now, whether they will hike rates 25 basis points or not. And I think markets pretty evenly split. First time in a long time going into this Fed meeting. So whatever happens, markets will move after this meeting. And if they don't raise rates, you know, it kind of puts their back against the wall to December. Because they have said, you know, the central banks, they like to follow through on what they said because they want to build credibility.
I know.
And if they don't raise rates, it kind of puts their backs to the wall for December. So,
it's a big deal, man. I know. I think it really has more to do with what you just said about credibility, man. It's like, you know, it's almost like, folks, the bond market's saying they're not going to raise rates. But it's almost like, man, they got to raise rates if they want any credibility. But, you know, the other side of that is that I don't think they care about anything, you know? They care about the banks making money. So if they do raise rates even by 25 basis points, the banks will make more money. So that's important, too. That's important to them, not to us.
Right, it's important. I was just going to say, it's important to them, certainly. But, you know, hey, they made this promise. It's going to be very interesting. And I think that markets are going to go into, unless we get a piece of news out of China, which, hey, is always possible, you know, markets are going to go into wait and see mode before that meeting. And then we should have some kind of fairly wild swings, I would say, afterwards. You know, crude oil, very interesting today. Let me pop a crude oil chart up there. The EIA came out with an API data show that inventories increased, but if you read the fine print on the weekly report, they said that U.S. production, which was at about 9.6 million barrels per day back in June, has dropped to about 9.1, and they're saying by 2016 it's going to drop to 8.8 million barrels a day, and that's what the market focused on, and that's why they took crude oil almost $2 higher.
Interesting. Okay.
So crude oil seems to be kind of comfortable with this $45 level, you know, here. So maybe we'll see it around here for a while. Volatility has come down. Daily volatility has come down from 95% to just under 90%, like 88% here. So it's kind of calming down a little bit here.
I know, but not much, right? It's been a wild ride, man, right?
Don't expect it to calm down for too long.
Yeah, I know, man. You know, I haven't been trading it. You know, normally, folks, when you're trading oil, you know, it's pretty clean, meaning, you know, you're not going to go up and down $1,000 at a pop, and which, you know.
Oh, you're going to do that today.
Sure, man, for sure.
Maybe 2,000.
Yeah, exactly.
Per contract.
Crazy
market here. So coffee had a really ugly day here, but I like that market. I mean, I think it's washing out, and it was down on decent volume today. Open interest is going up. We made a new low, new multi-year low today, but coffee's getting down to a level where, hey, you know, if we look back at what happened in 2014, just one piece of bad news could double the price quickly. So that's starting to look interesting as a bargain hunter here. Cocoa continues to rally, and that thing is up almost $300 a ton since the end of August. So that's been an interesting market. Some action in the softs. I think that this El Nino could possibly add some action in this soft commodity sector this coming year. But, you know, the traditional commodities, gold, silver, gold kind of dead here. Yesterday we had an ugly day in gold. We got down to 1,100.
I think one of the wild cards. Well, it's definitely a wild card. But I mean, the dollar couldn't hold price again. And what I was just going to say, the rumor was out there today that, you know, China was basically not just manipulating the yuan in China, they were pushing it around the world, you know, so it's kind of
interesting. Well, you know, interesting, Tom, gold is trading tick for tick with the dollar again now. You know, so yesterday the dollar was a little stronger, gold was down. Today the dollar's a little weaker, gold is up. So it is very highly correlated right now. We'll see what happens after the Fed meeting.
Yeah.
You know, the other metals, strong copper. Copper, let's talk about for a minute. That one is popped up here. I think that could get up to 250 to 260 on a technical rebound. But, hey, don't forget to sell it up there because copper is all about China. And eventually this sucker is going to come back down and test those lows again, the 220 and maybe even go to $2 in the coming months because copper is, you know, base metal. China slows, deflationary pressures, that weighs
heavily. Yeah, there's no juice in this at all today, at all.
All these base metals, all these base metal prices. But, hey, copper did get up above 240, 247 briefly.
Yeah, and, you know what's intriguing? Let me ask you, I mean, this is where this gets really wild about the whole China deal. You know, I was listening to, it was someone that was over in China, and this person wasn't necessarily a market person. He was a book writer. That's what he was, okay? But what he had done, Andy, is this. And, folks, he had gone from city to city to city. And, you know, he was talking about the ghost cities. But he was saying to the interviewer that, no, those ghost cities will get filled. You know what I mean? Because that's, you know, that is what does happen in China, okay? 2, 3, 4 years down the line to get filled. But he brought up a really wild point. And what he said, he says, the thing that he's still playing with in his head, he says, what I can't figure out is, he says, because the acceleration was so huge for so many years, he says, I just don't think there's going to be another acceleration like that in our lifetime, meaning that they could build that many, you know? And it was like, wow, that's intriguing just thinking that thought. Now, I know I've been around enough that it seems like that when you're in a generation, folks, but normally just give it 4 or 5 years and it happens again, you know, because the world just keeps getting bigger. But I thought that was really intriguing, do you know what I mean? To the point that, okay, you know, this has been an amazing commodity market, and the fact is, you know, can that happen again? You know, it's, well,
That is very true, and it's a very good point. But, you know, the very interesting thing is that in China, they have a very long-term view, long-term range.
Right.
Here, we're very quarter-to-quarter, and as day traders, sometimes we're day-to-day. So China, we became accustomed to Chinese growth, particularly commodity traders, you know, in the years between, let's say, 2004 and 2011.
Yep.
You know, we just became accustomed. It was just clear China's gonna buy every rally. They're going to buy every dip.
Right.
But now that they're slowing, you know, it's like, where's the buying coming from?
Yeah, no doubt.
A hell of a lot of buying.
Hey, stay right there, okay?
Sure.
Awesome. Andy and I are going to be coming right back, folks. Dow right now is up 36. NASDAQ's up 25. S&P's are up 2.5. We have gold up 760. Silver is up 5 cents. Bonds, 10 years down 10 ticks. 30's off 23. I'll be right back, folks.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These four-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien. Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 18, Nasdaq's up 21, S&P's a flat. And bottom line, folks, is that the sellers just keep coming in this marketplace. That supply line is a little too rough for this market at this particular point. Now, as you come over to TFNN, folks, you're going to see right in the front page, we do this Tiger Dollar Sale a couple times a year. We have it on right now. If you get subscriptions at TFNN or you plan on getting them in the future, great time to take advantage of the Tiger Dollar Sale. You can make either 20, 30, or 40% on your money as a bonus. The way that works, if you buy $500 in Tiger Dollars, you get $600. If you buy the 1,000, you end up getting 1,300. If you buy 1,500, you get 2,600 in Tiger Dollars. So check it out on the front page of TFNN. You have until this Sunday night. We're talking with our man, Mr. Andy Hecht, and we are talking commodities. Don't forget, coming right up after my program tonight at 5 o'clock, Andy's got a great program, 5 to 6. So, you know, we know commodities in general, Andy, they only can really stay under their production costs for a certain period of time, right? Andy?
You got me?
Yes.
Oh, okay, sorry. Production cost adjusts to, you know, market conditions too.
Yeah, cool. I remember saying that before. Okay,
We've seen oil come down, and energy prices are a huge component of production costs.
Cool. Yeah, so I get it. Okay.
Costs have come down. That's one reason.
Yeah.
The other thing is that, you know, if you're a copper miner, all right, lots of copper miners operated profitably at 85 cents a pound. Why? Because what they mined was higher grades of ore.
Yes.
Which had lower production costs. Now, when copper goes to $4 a pound, you can mine the very low grades of ore that are very high cost and make money.
And, so, and what that is, folks, so just picture in your backyard. Picture your backyard's a mine. And like the beginning, the front of your backyard has all this low grade ore. So that means a big rock only has like so much copper in it. Well, the back of your backyard, every rock you pick up is pure copper. That's what Andy's talking about. And it's really cool, man, how they can do that, right?
That's right. That's right. Like, you know, you look at the average cost of production of oil in the United States is probably around $40 a barrel, something like that.
Okay.
A little bit higher. In Saudi Arabia, you go back to your backyard, that backyard where you have all that copper, that pure copper.
Yeah.
You turn on the spigot for your hose where the water comes out and oil comes out. That's what it's like in Saudi Arabia.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
You know what I mean?
It's a big bathtub full.
It is. Hey, let's talk about something really important here.
Okay.
Football season starts tonight.
Yeah.
That's right.
Patriots.
So let me ask you, is Tom Brady in the locker room now, right now, getting those balls nice and soft for tonight's game?
No, he's got all his trainers doing that.
Okay. I love it. I think they should that should be an interesting game tonight against Pittsburgh. I always like Patriots Pittsburgh.
Oh
game.
Man, that, those He's Pittsburgh good. Fans are a trip, no doubt, man. Yeah.
They are, but it's in Foxborough.
Yeah, it is.
Right. So it's going to be interesting. It's going to be fun game, and it's the kickoff of the big season. So
it is,
that's always
man. Exciting.
That tells us the summer's over.
I know. Except that we
by the way, you wouldn't know it if you walked out in my backyard today. It's about 108 degrees.
Is it really?
Oh yeah.
Wow.
We're having a little end of Indian Vegas summer here.
Well, I hope it gets cool by October 15th and 16th, because if you happen to be in Vegas, folks, the Traders Expo is out there. We're going to be out there. Andy's going to be out there. We got a booth out there, so come visit us. It's going to be at the Paris Hotel.
Oh, the Paris will be nice. A little bit quieter than Caesars.
Is it? Yeah.
Yeah, it's nice. It's a nice hotel, so it'll be fun.
I hope that they get we'll have to go down the strip for the crap tables.
Absolutely. And by the way, I'm really hoping that this year we see the Giants play the Patriots again in the Super Bowl, so that we can have, you know, kind of another grudge match, you know, from I know the Patriot fans want to beat the Giants one of these times. In the big game.
I
got to tell you, this year I kind of like Indianapolis. I kind of like Andrew Luck. Have you watched him?
I haven't.
He's looking good.
Yeah.
They have a strong team. They're gonna give Brady and Belichick a run for their money. The Indianapolis this year should be a good season.
Wild, man. Okay, anyway. Brother. Well, listen, right. Man. We appreciate the update. We look forward to the show. Of course, we look forward to that grain report tomorrow morning.
Absolutely, it'll be interesting.
Hey, so when the grain reports come out, they it's just like the movies, right? The markets are stopped before they come out, right? Just like trading places.
Yeah, it's like Clarence Speaks walks down to the floor, and actually now in the electronic age, it just flashes up there.
Yeah.
And you know, analysts have certain expectations, and basically the markets move whether they come in higher or lower than expectations. What we saw in August is we saw the grain markets trash because they said, hey, big bumper crops. So the market's expecting more of the same, more big bumper crops, and these grain prices are pretty low here. So I think that if it comes out, it's ample crops, everyone's going to expect that. Any kind of decrease in what the USDA said in August could cause some very interesting fireworks in grains. I think the downside's limited, upside potentially explosive, but not too much because they're far along.
What is the story with, you know, I remember years ago, you know, Russia would buy a lot of wheat off us and all that. Is that still on, or how does that work between us and Russia?
Russia's a big producer of wheat these days.
Okay.
Russia and Ukraine, big producers
of
wheat.
And I think we're not trading with Russia anymore, right? Is that what's
going on? Oh, we got sanctions.
Yeah, right.
We got sanctions all over the place. That's what's killing Europe. I mean, that's part of the problem with the European. Listen, European economy is in trouble. We should talk about that for a minute. There's a lot of the biggest problem that they face right now. Okay, look, we know that growth is slow and unemployment is very high there. Their biggest trading partner has been Russia.
Yes.
And that's killing them that they're not trading with Russia. But these flow of immigrants coming into Europe is going to cost so much money. And Germany's taking them in. It's a humanitarian cause here for Germany and for other nations in the north. This is going to dilute the economy. We got to keep our eyes on that euro. It's a difficult situation over there.
There is no doubt. I mean, I think, you know, it's really nice what Germany's doing. I mean, I was surprised, actually, you know, that they were taking the lead on that, which is great, because it is pretty intense, because those countries are small. And I know, you know, when everyone's fighting for jobs, you know, there's a lot of animosity in that whole deal. There's no doubt.
Absolutely. Man. And by the way, by Germany opening their mouth and saying, hey, they're going to take in X number, do you know that I saw today the flood now is even bigger? Now, people are saying, hey, Germany's taking us, and they're coming like crazy. So this is going to be, and this is a very dangerous journey that a lot of them take by boat and over mountains, and a very, very difficult journey. And they get there, you know, a lot of people are being lost. It's really quite a tragic story, this exodus from Syria and Iraq.
It's actually hard to believe when you think that we're in 2015, folks, and this is happening, except that. That being said, the last few nights I've been watching the Civil War, and you know, by that documentary writer, And it's just amazing that when you think about the Civil War, it only happened like 100 years ago. It's like, oh, my God.
You know what, Tom? We get very used to our comfortable life here.
I know.
If you go to places in Africa, go to the Ivory Coast, go to Ghana, go to the Republic of Guinea, it's like the 1500s. So the world is very different depending upon where you live.
That's a fact, man. How do we get so lucky, man? I always think about that. You ever think about that, folks? It's like, okay, how do we get so lucky that we're born here? It's like, that's amazing, man. Listen, brother, have a great one. Have a safe one. We look forward to speaking to you at 5 o'clock.
Talk to you soon.
Stay there, right there, folks. We'll come right back. Dow Industrials right now are up 63. NASDAQ's up 35. S&P's are up 6. We're going to be right back, folks.
The TFNN End of Summer Tiger Dollar Sale is here. We've just announced our best Tiger Dollar Sale is back for 5 days only. This week, you can get up to a 40% bonus on whatever you spend when you purchase Tiger Dollars. Tiger Dollars are the best way to lock in added value and extra savings for any of your TFNN products or services. Normally, we only offer a 10, 15, or 20% bonus, but for this week only, we've doubled all our bonuses and are giving away 20, 30, and even 40% bonuses on all Tiger Dollar purchases. Tiger Dollars can be used for any TFNN product or service and never expire. So whether you're a subscriber already or planning on trying out a product soon, now is a perfect time to get your Tiger Dollars. For more information and to purchase your Tiger Dollars today, visit the front page of TFNN.com for all the details. Remember, this sale ends Sunday, so act now and don't miss out. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 46. You get the NASDAQ up 33. S&Ps are up 4.5. And inside this market, folks, bottom line is that you have some sellers. You know, it comes up to the supply line, sell it off from the supply line, get a really nice intraday bounce. And bottom line, as we come into this close, they sell that baby off also. Intraday out here today, when you take a look at the S&Ps, we're still swinging about 35 points. The high out here today was 67. The low thus far has been 28, so with 40 bucks. And right now we're at 48. Inside the NQs, what you have is that that swing also has been pretty dramatic. Not dramatic, but the high out here was 327. The low is 226. Yeah, so you get 91 points. Right now you're at 4-2-9-1. What you are going to have out here is that you're going to have the spies, the Qs, the diamonds, the IWM. Each one of them have gone or tried to get into the bars of yesterday, and thus far each one of them do have lower volume. So yesterday I couldn't handle it. Today you're trying to get up into those bars and they haven't been able to handle it with like 10 minutes left. If we take a look at the IWM, what you have with the IWM, we've done 27 million shares. That was going into yesterday at 40 million. So that's a big failure, no doubt. The Qs, you're dealing with 43 million. I believe that's around the same. We were 47 million yesterday. The SPYs, what you're dealing with is that the SPYs, you're dealing with 137 million, and that is going into 149 million. The diamonds inside the Dow Industrials, that is dealing with 7.9 million in your 7.8 million. So the diamonds are the only ETF structure that actually was pushing into that level, and it is pushing into that level with a little more juice. Some of the higher volume stocks in this low volume market, this is what you have. Lululemon is just getting killed, man. That thing is down 20%. It's down $10.98. Monster volume too, by the way, man. They're just getting out of that thing so fast they can't see straight. Mobileye is down 390. That's trading at 44.44. You have GE up 15. Let's take a look at. You have Honeywell up 64. Walmart's down 96. If we go over to Walmart, let's look at Walmart again, because Walmart, you know, basically was a big heads up prior to the downdraft that has occurred on August 24th. What Walmart had done, Walmart had broken down after a 12-year consolidation, had gone topside. And Walmart right now, you know, this is a problem. Walmart is trading into the 24th. And when you trade into the 24th, folks, okay, and you are a large cap and you have billions of dollars, the probability goes much higher that the indices themselves will go back into that 24th. The opening of Walmart on the 24th was $63.74. It went down to 61. Right now it traded 64.14. That's a problem. That's a very large problem. If we take a look at 3M, 3M, excuse me, 3M is trading at 140, 62. The high of the 24th was 142. Low 138. That's saying, guess what? That also wants to get into that level. If we look at DuPont, DuPont's even more problematic. So check this out with DuPont. This is pretty insane, actually. DuPont is trading at $48.60. The low was 48.01. The high was 51.10. DuPont wants to break the low of the 24th. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We're going to be coming back with a few numbers. Restoration Hardware is coming out after the close. Dow up 69. NASDAQ up 39. S&P's up 7.5. We're going to be right back.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Nick in Tampa. Hey, Nick, what's going on?
Tom O'Brien, it is an absolute pleasure.
Thanks so much, man. We appreciate you calling.
No problem. Dude, I've been listening to your show for about 2 years now, and it has just been wonderful. I listen to you, Basil, Andy. You guys do an amazing job.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling out here with us.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great time, great day, safe day, and, of course, have a great night. Surround yourself with people who believe you can. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials finish up 76, NASDAQ up 39, S&P's up 650, gold contract up $7.50, trading at $1,109 an ounce. Silver up 6 cents at $14.64, platinum flat at $9.80 an ounce, copper up 2 pennies at $2.45 a pound, light sweet crude up $1.54 at $45.64 a barrel, bonds. Excuse me, folks. The 10-year down 11.6, trading out at 127.02. 30-year off 1 point, 153.23. King dollar down 495 ticks at 95.51. The euro up 71 at 112, and the yen flat at 120.64. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? You get the SPY right now. The SPY, we are trading out at a price point of 195.85. And what the SPY did out here today, folks, is this. Yesterday, you tried to get to higher price. It failed on volume, failed on price. We got to a price point out here of 199.47. You did volume of 149 million. That 149 was going against your supply line of 507 million as well as 346 million. Couldn't handle it. Today, you did 148 million versus 149 of yesterday. You didn't get the price going. You didn't get the volume going. Can't handle it. You get sellers in the marketplace. Then NQs, the NDX 100, the three Qs, same setup. The Qs today did 47 million. I think we did 45 yesterday. We did 47 yesterday. Failed yesterday at a price point of 106.31. We didn't get to 106.31 today. You got to 105.68. You closed out at 104.99. Same type of setup. The after the market closed out here, Restoration Hardware, let's go take a look at this one. RH, Restoration Hardware, closed today at, was down $1.47, closed at $91.06. That's trading right now at $89.95. Numbers go like this on Restoration Hardware. Their revenue is up 17%. Their net revenue is $506 million. Their adjusted earnings per share was 60 to 65 cents. This is a classic too. So they made their number. Their number was 84 cents. They made 85 cents. That's the bottom line number. I'm trying to find the top line right now. Our bottom line is that if you take a look at where this baby is set up, it's already sold off from the 105 area. Right now, it's in the area of the 24th, which is the downdraft. The high of the 24th was 95, the low was 86, and right now we're at 89. That's a monster heads up, folks, that Restoration Hardware is also going to be going after the lows of the 24th. Those lows of the 24th are real huge problems, folks, okay? Because what we've had, when I was just finishing the first hour, you have DuPont down there, you have 3M down there. That's where equities want to trade right now. Gold contract, what do we have with the gold contract? Bottom line, we need price spread. We need volume, we need all of the above. Gold today was up $7. It needs a lot more than up $7. It rejected lower price yesterday, had lighter volume, did everything it was supposed to do. Now what we need wide price spread, you need accelerated volume. If we go over to the and we have a shot at that, and this is why, folks. If you go over to the dollar index broke today. And when I say broke, what it means is that it couldn't handle higher price. It kept trying to get into its minor swing point. Now, the amazing part about this, its minor swing point, you know, we're talking only 96, 92, and it couldn't handle it. It's like, okay, that means someone's selling dollars. You know, China's selling dollars. That's the bottom line. We know that they're selling their foreign reserves. They just don't know how their reserves went down like $500 billion. You just don't know how much of that are dollars versus euros versus everything else. What you do have is this. That's the first part. Make a long story short, dollar broke with volume today. 56,000 contracts. You do have the rollover in the contract also, which makes the deal go up. We're at 90, 572. The high of the downdraft of the 24th is 95.27. It's going to go after that 95.27. And when we did break that 95.27, by the way, that looks like the dollar index can actually go to 85, which is going to be pretty intense. Now, what also more than likely is putting pressure on the dollar is this, is that if we go over, watch this, you know, I was looking at a story today, and what it's about is the borrowing binge that is going on right now in Europe and in euros, okay? Bottom line is that you have a huge amounts of companies that are selling bonds in euros. Apple sold bonds in euros for the second time, increasing the amount the iPhone maker has raised in global debt offerings since 2013 by $55 billion. Apple today sold $2.3 billion in bonds maturing in 8 years and 12 years. Okay, so watch how this works also, folks. When you have an American company that you're selling in euros, what ends up happening is that you need euros in order to basically pay the interest. Now, in Apple's case, it's real possible. I suspect in Apple's case, they have so much money overseas that money is overseas. That is not the case, however, in the amount of U.S. companies that have been selling European bonds, and it's been huge. There's no two ways about it. That also may be putting pressure on the dollar, because if you and I were an American company and doing mostly business and trying to save a couple dollars, because it's quite expensive, it's a huge amount of money that you're actually saving, not just a couple dollars. You know, our 10-year is at 2.2. Germany is at 0.6%. France is at 1%. Italy is 1.8. So the bottom line is that they're probably saving a couple percent on billions of dollars, which is huge, huge money. That being said, what ends up happening, the way it gets done is this. You have to transfer dollars into euros in order to basically have the deal done. What does that set up? That sets up more selling inside the dollar market. That puts buying pressure on the euro, because when you look at it on a fundamental basis, it makes no sense that the euro is going up and the dollar is going down. But technically, that's what it looks like it wants to do. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We're going to be coming right back. Dow Industrials finished up 76. NASDAQ up 39. S&P's up 7. We're going to be right back, folks.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A shares hot or not? If you trade China A shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-Share Bull and Bear ETFs. China A-Shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Folks, we had the Dow Industrials finish up 76. NASDAQ was up 29. S&Ps are up 5.5. And we're going to have our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, up right now. And don't forget, folks, Basil has an outstanding show right here at TFNN. Every trading day, 11 to 12 Eastern Standard Time. Get that right on your cell phone, tfnn.mobi. If you'd like to get Tiger TV, just go to tfnn.com. You'll see the little box on the right-hand side that says Watch Tiger TV. Click here. And then underneath it, it says Watch Tiger TV on mobile. Just hit that. Our servers understand what type of device you're on, and you'll get Tiger TV, the audio and the video. Now, tonight, folks, you know, we've had an amazing volatile market. Our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, is going to be doing a workshop tonight for his subscribers. 6 to 7 Eastern Standard Time. You can be a subscriber right now. You can test drive his newsletter 1 month, absolutely free. Come over here to TFNN. You can sign up right now. You can be in the workshop tonight. Now, if you can't make it, you can still get the workshop, folks, because the workshop's going to be archived on your page for 1 full month. Basil Chapman, what's going on?
Tom, you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Hi, how are you?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm very well, thank you.
So tell us, what are you going to be talking about tonight?
Well, you were just speaking about the volatility. And what is volatility? Volatility really is an oscillation. It is where you start off at a certain level, and through excitement, through nervousness, whatever, there's an increase or an acceleration of energy, either up or down. And what we're seeing in the market is really a fractal of human life. I mean, this is just like everyday events, except that sometimes there are deeper crises than other times. And that's reflected. If you look at the Dow, I'm showing the Dow chart right now, there's a pattern that I was looking at which says that this particular formation should go into an arch and make a lowercase h, and that h should then make some kind of a low and then try to rebound and make yet another arch formation, and that becomes an M formation, lowercase m. Well, that's the oscillation that we're seeing. And what we've also noticed, if you look at the this is the volatility index, and that's what we'll be talking about tonight, the historical context of where we are right now, where what is it doing in relation to other times. The VIX index, which is basically, I consider it really simply a measure of buying power or selling power. Of course, there's a whole complex way of a mathematical formula, but I like to simplify just to make it put into layman terms. Is there increased buying in the volatility index? Just like when bonds go up, yields come down. In this case, when the VIX, the volatility index, goes up, prices come down. So I'm showing a weekly chart, and this weekly chart of the volatility index shows you all these spikes to the upside. Let me expand this chart, and you'll see. There was a spike to the upside, and then all of a sudden, as it made a high, in the bar after the high, each time was a big red candle to the downside. So basically what we saw, I'll talk about this tonight as well, is the speed of nervousness of the selling in the market showing up as buying in the volatility index was very quickly ameliorated, and the price came down. Why is this time possibly different to the other times? Well, you'll see 1, 2, 3. This is just what I'm showing on the chart. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five times over the period of a year and a half, you've got a volatility index that screamed into the 21 area, 22, then it went to 31 with the Greek chaos, then it pulled back. And yet, it pulled back so sharply. And you remember that the market, our market, we kept saying, how come we haven't had more than a 3 to a 5% correction? Well, look what's just happened. The volatility index screamed to 53.29, what I call the China plunge. It really wasn't. The crisis 2 weeks ago was nothing like the news headlines that we had seen for the Greek crisis, the bank crisis. So this is the big, this is the interesting thing. We've had 2 weeks since that August 24th spiral to the upside. Look at the candle of last week. Look at the candle so far of this week. The week's just, it's not yet over. And yet we're above the 9-period exponential moving average, and the volatility index is above the 200-period moving average. I'm going to be discussing what this means, I believe, to your portfolio, to the way you can look at the markets, what the implication is in terms of the overall market perspective, where we are in relation to the volatility index itself, trading at 24, half the price that it was just two, three weeks ago.
Sure, because the market makers basically still want big money for insurance.
And that's the issue, that I'm going to be talking to the fact that when the volatility index stays at a certain point and above the level that was a base, and now it's raised the base,
yes,
it implies that fund managers, especially hedge fund managers and professional investors, are looking at insurance. And that insurance shows up as a higher volatility index. And then I'm going to talk about, we can talk about the volatility index, but as far as I'm concerned, it really has to do with the candles that are forming in the monthly chart of a number of the indexes. And here I've got the Dow chart, and you'll see the candle of last month. I call it the Chapman Wave Roman candle. Reason being, in a Roman candle, when you light it, it just blows up. And that's the candle that we've got to watch so closely. Why? Because in the methodology that I use, if the Dow starts to trade underneath 16,000 for 2 out of 3 sessions, that's going to impact the weekly chart negatively and immediately impact the monthly chart to say, we will be testing the lows of 15,370. So that's going to be critical. I'm going to be talking about that candle. I'm going to be talking about that candle in relation to the very same candle we saw back, if I can just do this for 1 second, back in 2007. It was exactly the same. Here comes the candle, 2007. Look at this. You had a peak. In that case, it was a peak F in October at 14,198 in the Dow. The very next candle was what I call the Roman candle. And it took 2 months, and the next candle broke it, and then you were on your way down. Is that the implication? Yeah, and I'm going to be talking about the different implications, what I believe it means. But most importantly, it is the relationship of the numbers that I look at in the volatility index, that anyone who comes to the webinar who subscribe will get a free subscription for 30 days. They'll learn how I look at the volatility index every single day. I discuss it. And what I how I use it for the trading possibilities intraday. And the most important thing that I think of right now, though, I give the parameters to look for over the coming 2 weeks in the Dow, the S&P, in relation to the volatility index. And I'll explain what could happen if certain levels are taken out. And that actually implies to the upside as well, because I had spoken on my show today, I said, watch this very closely, because this lowercase h pattern in the daily that goes to the M pattern can actually go trading sideways, just like we saw today, for a lot longer than your patience. And at some point, we start to break key support in the Dow, that would be 15,900. If that's taken out, then we're on our way to the low 15,000s.
So it's pretty intriguing that, yeah, the Dow might have been up 60, but, you know, when you look at some of these large Dow stocks that you do like to look at, they're at their lows of the 24.
General Electric, IBM, Triple M.
DuPont.
DuPont, United Technologies.
Yeah.
This is telling us something about not just the cyclicals. I think it's telling us about the strong dollar. It's telling us about the relationship of the big caps to what's happening in the market right now. But that VIX is going to be so important.
And folks,
really,
you can sign up. You can sign up right now. Come to the front page of TFNN. You're going to see it right on the front page. You can test drive, get a newsletter, 30 days, get the workshop tonight. Basil, thank you so much. We look forward to the workshop in 45 minutes.
Thank you very much, Tom. Have a great evening.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
TFNN has just announced a brand new morning lineup that is geared specifically for traders in this volatile traders market. Every morning at 8 a.m., John Logan starts things off with his daily program, The Global Market Pulse. At 9 a.m., Larry Pesavento trades the market during the market open Monday through Friday on Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom O'Brien hosts the Money Masters for the hour, and Basil Chapman hosts his Tiger Technician's Hour at 11 a.m. From 8 a.m. till noon every market day, these traders are with you as they provide up-to-the-second market information so that you can make the most educated and profitable trades possible. The new TFNN morning lineup is happening right now. Tune in to see for yourself what kind of actionable trading discussion they have each morning, Monday through Friday, starting at 8 a.m., live only on Tiger TV at TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We had the Dow Industrials finish up the 76, NASDAQ up 39, S&Ps are up $6. And we go take a look at some of these equities that came out after the close. This is ZUMZ. So let's take a look at this baby. What you're going to see here is ZUMZ. What this company does, this is a... This is a sports retailer. And evidently, they're not selling anything because the stock closed at $21.66. It's trading right now at $17.60. And what this baby did, okay, this is dangerous. Okay, well here, let's see what they did number wise first. Okay, so number wise, this is what they did. Their earnings per share was 11 cents. Same store sale comps were down 7 to 9%. The estimate, the revenue estimate was 180 million. They made 179. And that would have been revenue was in line and they're a little shot on the earnings per sale. But guess what? It is a monster ABC down. This thing is getting blown out of the water. It's down $4 after the close. What's more important, I think, though, is this. The 24th, folks, as I just talked with Basil, we were talking about the market in general. What you have is these equities are trading very close to the 24th right now, and that's a problem. This one here just blown it away. It's an ABC structure on the way down. You want to see another one that came out that blew away its structure this morning and continues lower? It's Wynn Resorts. Wynn Resorts, you know, bottom line, this has been a one-way track for Wynn. Wynn is an ABC structure on the way down. Took out its B point, took it out with volume. It's down 337 today. Your B point on this Wynn was $70.51 at 3.9 million. Takes that 7.7 million. That's an ABC structure down to the 56 area. FNSR. We take a look at this baby. This baby just came out with numbers also. This is pretty amazing, actually. So this is fiber optic subsystems network performance. This closed at $14.91. This is trading right now at $13.74. Numbers go like this. Oh, this is a trip. So this CEO is departing too. Okay, so revenue, they're looking, earnings per share, the estimate was 26 cents, they made 23. Their bottom line, top line, the estimate was $318 million, and they made $314 million. What do you have? Same type of setup, folks. This is an equity that has gone straight down from 23. On the 24th, you had 14.23. We're banging into that today with volume. You know, on the 24th, we did 1.9 million shares. Yesterday, you did 2.2 million. Right now, you're at 1.8. You're breaking those lows, and so you're at 13.62. The low point here is 14.23. You got another ABC down. So the A point on that is 17.70. You got another 350 down, which is going to get you to the 12.86 mark. Big problem. Restoration Hardware, that also came out with numbers. The key is Restoration Hardware, RH. Same type of setup, meaning not an ABC structure on the way down when I say same type of structure. What it is that Restoration closed at $91.06. That is trading right now at, well, it looks like it's trading flat right now. It was 90.33. We'll see. This was more than likely is going to bounce around a bit. It was at 89.60. The point is, this came down with volume today, and it's trading inside the 24th. Lululemon, it just got absolutely smoked out here today. This thing really took it deep. Lululemon, if you take a look at the clothing maker, Lululemon. Was trading yesterday at a price point of 66. You're at 53 today, and it has everything. It has volume. It broke swing points with volume, broke all of the above. If you take a look at this, and we put this on a weekly basis, this is an ABC down on a weekly basis. So you got, well, this is on its way down. It's down 10 bucks today. We did 31 million shares. This is on its way down to the 46 level, 46. We'll see whether we get any strength when it gets into the 46 level. And this is absolutely a classic. And if you take a look at Lululemon and you put this on a monthly basis, what you're going to see is that the first high that you made in Lululemon was May of 2012. That high was made with no volume whatsoever, $81. It hung up there for a few weeks. Then guess what? It came off the highs with volume. When you come off those highs with volume, it's just nasty. So your first leg, went back up and tested that leg, comes off the highs with volume again. We go from 82 down to 36. 36 was generated in 2014, June of 2014, last year. You do a counter trend bounce. Now we're going to be going right down, testing that level again, which is the 46.24 level. The 46.24 level, by the way, is the highs of the lows. We'll see whether it can break down at that particular level. When you do look at the Dow stocks, folks, this is the So we have these high volume lows on the 24th. The real key is that, is this an ABC down that's going to break the 24th? Or is it going to test the 24th, reject the 24th, want to go to a higher price? Little by little, the market is releasing that information. If we go over and we first look at DuPont, you know, huge company, great company, all of the above, right? Well, when you look at DuPont, it's like, okay, you know, you've gone from a price point of $76 to $48. The low of the 24th, never mind the trading range of the 24th, the 24th, Dow traded from 51 to 48. Well, we're at 48 again. This thing looks like it's going to blow it away tomorrow. We go look at 3M. 3M, they've been trying to pump 3M a million different ways. 3M came out today and said, I believe Goldman was going to start marketing one of the companies to sell. Yeah, 3M hired Goldman to explore options for their health data business. Guess what? It didn't do a thing for the stock. 3M is trading at 140.78. Now, that's not at the lows. That is in the range, though, by a buck and a half. The high of the 24th was 142. You know, so that's in the range. United Technologies, UTX. We take a look at United Technologies. When we say United Technologies, that is also right in the range, UTX. And that's deeper in the range. United Technologies, the high was 93. You're at 91.40 right now. The low is 87. You know, Big Blue. We go over to Big Blue. We take a look at Big Blue. Big Blue out here is trading at a price point of 146.20. And Big Blue is also deep right into it. The high of the 24th was 147.70. The low is 142. These babies want to test those lows. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. Come right back.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a two-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge for daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today.
With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. And folks, if you do have any subscriptions right now at TFNN, any newsletters, any software, if you're thinking of getting any in the next year, we have our Tiger Dollar sale going on. And the way this Tiger Dollar sale works is this. We do it a couple times a year. As you go over to TFNN, this sale started 2 days ago. It goes until Sunday, this coming Sunday. So you get four more days. Today's Thursday, four more days. The way it works is this. You buy $500 of Tiger Dollars, you get a 20% bonus, you get $600. If you buy $1,000, you get a 30% bonus, you get $1,300. If you buy $1,500, you get a 40% bonus or an additional $600 equals $2,100. There's on Tiger Dollars, there's no expiration date. They're totally transferable and they're good for all products at TFNN. So check it out on the front page of TFNN. Of course, don't forget, I'm Mr. Basil Chapman. He's going to be doing that volatility workshop at 6 o'clock tonight. Now, if we go overseas, let's go take a look at overseas. So last night overseas, what you had is that the market's down overseas. The prior night, okay, I want to go look at the Nikkei first, because this is what you had, folks. The Nikkei had gone up 7.7% the prior night. Now, that being said, the Nikkei had gone down 17% from August 11th. Okay, so August 11th, the Nikkei's trading at 20,900. 2 nights ago, it's at 17,400. You get a bump, and that little bump comes up with big volume. Not as large as how we went down. So what does that set up? It's pretty intense. I suspect, first off, what you'll get is this. So the Nikkei bounced on 2 billion shares. It was going on the way down on 2.7 billion and 3.3 billion. So the way the Nikkei looks to me right at this particular point, it's like, okay, you can get up another, 400, 500 points. 500 pretty easy. We're at 18,300 right now. 18,800 is game. And more than likely, what we'll see tomorrow is that that'll test the high of two prior nights ago, lighter volume, and then you go back downtown. If we go over to China, the markets in China no doubt have been vicious. Now, this is granted after China had gone up so dramatically. This is not the first time that China went to the moon either, folks. If I bring you back in China for a second, just so you can see the correlation. In 2006, the Chinese market went from November 2005, China was trading at 1,074. So remember that number. Let's just say 1,074. That was November of 2005. By October of 2007, so 2 years later, China was at 6,100. So you're talking about going up 5,000 points, okay, in 2 years. 1 year later, China went from 6,100 down to 1,600. It was exactly a year, too. Okay, so the correlation, when you hear that this is the end of the world in China, it's like, even when I look at it, I said, this is really intriguing. So what the Chinese government is claiming is that the first time that this was going up, well, they're not claiming this, okay, but what analysts are claiming is that the first time this went up, it was mostly institutions that were in the marketplace, wasn't the end of the world. This time, so let's go over what China's done this time. So China started last July. It was at 2,033. By this June, so 11 months, China was at 5,100. So you went up 3,000 points. Well, that's 150%. It's certainly not 400% like went up last time. Now what has it done? It's gone from 5,100, got into 2,800, 2,850. It looks to me, I'm gonna pull this back on a weekly now, that number one, China's not done going down. Number two, they're trying to get, they've done just about anything and everything to try to stop the market from trading. And what that specifically means is that they put callers on the market. over 60% of the stocks are not trading, period. And they, you know, basically locking people up if they write anything bad about the market. Well, what's screaming out here is still that this baby wants to go test 2665. You know, so we'll see how this whole thing shakes out. But that's how technically that market is set up. And we'll find out if the technicals overtake governments. And I suspect they will, of course. Hang Seng, you go to the Hang Seng. So what the Hang Seng did last night, Hang Seng is down 2.5%. Hang Seng is a little problem child. The reason, you know, there's still, the A shares trade in Hang Seng. They're still not trading some of them, but the Hang Seng can't get out of its way, man. The Hang Seng is not in the at lows. It looks that when we take a look at this Hang Seng, the Hang Seng wants to run down to like 16,170. And that's a huge problem because, of course, for the Hang Seng, it's $5,000 more. Now, the Hang Seng has already come off 7,000. The Hang Seng was at 28,500 in April and in May, actually. Yeah, May too. So it's already come down 7. It looks like it wants to come down another 5. We go over to the UK. We take a look at the UK, and one of the main reasons that we're doing all of this, folks, is that all these markets are correlated. The reason that they're correlated, by the way, has to do with this, we're a one-world market, and all these large funds that you read about, they invest everywhere. So when they lose money one place, guess what happens? As they're losing money one place, they have to grab something off the table. That's where the selling begets the selling. That's the correlation that I'm talking about. So if we take a look at the FTSE, FTSE right now is at 61.55. This baby tested the highs that were generated in 2007, couldn't handle them, pulled back, has some juice in the way on the pullback. We'll see if this can handle the 5,900. Now, the FTSE is not in that bad a shape. You know, the FTSE is at 61.55. That it would first have to get into the 5,900 in order to get the lows of 2011. You know, we had talked quite a bit before got there that I felt that the market wanted to go to the lows of 2014. It did that. You know, we're right there in the FTSE right now. The top of that, the high of that was 6,600, the low is 6,000. Now the bars and the months that the market looks like it's going to go test, folks, and this is right across a lot of markets, is October of 2011. If we go take a look at the DAX in Germany, what you have with the DAX in Germany, that's at 10,200. That's off its highs of 12,300. So it's, you know, down 2,000 bucks, which is not the end of the world because, you know, the DAX went from 3,500 up to 12,000. And the DAX is sitting right at the highs. Well, actually, it hit 93.38. So the DAX had already hit the highs of the lows of 2014. And I suspect it's going to test them again. Now, that test was done at 2.1 billion versus 2.6. So for you bulls out here, the DAX, you really want to keep your eye on because the DAX held that area. And it held it with 500 million lighter shares. That's a lot. So if you go back down there again, you hold again, that's going to be a good indication to look at the DAX as to where our own markets are even going because the NASDAQ likes trading like the DAX trades. This is Tom O'Brien. This is TFNN. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow finished up 76. NASDAQ up 39. S&P's up 7.72 points. We'll be right back.
The TFNN end of summer Tiger Dollar sale is here. We've just announced our best Tiger Dollar sale is back for 5 days only. This week, you can get up to a 40% bonus on whatever you spend when you purchase Tiger Dollars. Tiger Dollars are the best way to lock in added value and extra savings for any of your TFNN products or services. Normally, we only offer a 10, 15, or 20% bonus, but for this week only, we've doubled all our bonuses and are giving away 20, 30, and even 40% bonuses on all Tiger Dollar purchases. Tiger Dollars can be used for any TFNN product or service and never expire. So whether you're a subscriber already or planning on trying out a product soon, now is a perfect time to get your Tiger Dollars. For more information and to purchase your Tiger Dollars today, visit the front page of TFNN.com for all the details. Remember, this sale ends Sunday, so act now and don't miss out. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per a $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
Join Andy Hecht as he shows you how to make money in commodities. The Commodities Hour, next on TFNN.
Welcome back, folks. Yesterday, Apple, bottom line, brought out its new iPhone 6, brought out a iPad Pro, that's what they're calling it, brought out a another TV device. And Apple itself, today it was up $2.50, really hasn't been able to move off the lows that were generated out here. The high in Apple is 134, you're at 112. What is intriguing, however, though, is this. So check this out. This is where they're going to move some phones. Apple decided that they're going to start financing and leasing iPhones to consumers. And so this is how this program works. You can buy an iPhone 6 starting at $27 a month for 2 years. Through the iPhone upgrade program, you can upgrade to a new one once a year at monthly payments at $32. So if you want an iPhone 6, you pay $27 a month, you are locked in for 2 years. If you want to be locked in at $32, if they come out with another phone, you can upgrade once a year. That's a big number. It's going to be interesting watching this whole thing shake out. And it's going to be interesting to see what ends up happening in the correlation of the Androids. T-Mobile was the first carrier that came out with that type of financing. In response to Apple's announcement Wednesday, T-Mobile introduced an iPhone leasing program for $20 a month over 18 months with an option to upgrade the phone whenever you want. That's interesting. So there's a couple of different things that are going to end up happening here. Number one, bottom line is that I suspect phones were going to get expensive for us. They're still going to be pretty inexpensive. And this is going to be about the carriers, folks. That's how this shakes out, because each and every one of these carriers have different deals. And it seems that the deals, I guess we pay for the phones at some point. But I can tell you, we've had Sprint for years. I've had Sprint for, even as a company. And it's such a sweet deal. It's insane. I mean, it seems like every time you turn around, you can get a new phone. You pay... I think even for the best phones, we pay maybe $100, $150. And the data, what has happened, the amount of data you get, we never go over the data. I mean, it's huge, and it has been huge in the bulk deals. But It looks to me like the phone wars are going to basically start up once again. We're going to see that start up. If we go up and we take a look at the oil market, what we've had out here today is oil moved higher once again. Volatility, as we were talking with Andy, heck, is huge in oil, no doubt. We're at 45.64. Now, that being said, if we go over and take a look at Exxon and Chevron, they're not moving. You know, if these are, listen, they're great stocks. I wouldn't be biting on them just yet, because the way that they are trading, it looks like they also are going to test, at least on the weekly basis, the highs of their lows, and it's real possible that they'll test their lows. And, you know, on a fundamental basis, I could see that you have the aspect that there's a huge amount of oil out there right now, and there's going to be more oil out there in another 3, 4, 5 months. Inside the marketplace. So a lot of this is going to continge on, you know, how much oil is going to be used in the winter. And what we did have out there today is that natural gas, the numbers come out in natural gas. And natural gas was was all over the place out here today. It got into a high of 280, rejected that high. It's trading at 275 right now. But yet it had volume up at that high. So, you know, natural gas has been trying to make a bottom forever. You know, we go take a look at the financials, because the financials are the last ones that broke down, and the XLF. What you have with the XLF, that little baby, come on, baby, let's do that XLF quick. The XLF, listen, can't get out of the range of the 24th. That's a problem. You stay right there, folks. My man, Mr. Andy Hecht's going to be coming up next, growling a problem with you. And always remember, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, fly with it. Everything you need is right inside you. Grab it and have a blast, folks. Thanks for being here. Look forward to speaking tomorrow.